Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to solve unable or getting error when trying to post or fetch data by using Node.js in both MySQL and MongoDB. So irrespective of the database, solution is going to be same for both MySQL as well as MongoDB. We are just going to use the exact same Node.js code over here. And I have listed some of the common mistakes that people make, and even I made when I was like creating some CRUD operations in both MySQL and MongoDB using Node.js. So if you are making any mistakes in the 6 points, you can just rectify it now. So let me begin with the first point. The first one is write operation when sending. So this means that whenever you are doing or performing any particular operation like post, put or get, delete, you will need to like also select that particular operation over here. So many people just forget to do that. They will be having post over here and they will just keep it to get operation. They will just select get over here. And if you just send it, obviously you will be getting an error. So many people, and even I did this mistake many times. So just check the operation. What you are doing, you need to be like having that particular operation over here. So this is the first mistake. And second one is a local host path. This is one of the most important things. You need to be like really careful with the spellings over here. And another important thing is that you need to have HTTP. It is not HTTPS. If you use HTTPS, you will be getting error. And you need to be careful with this colon and double slash and even the port number as well as this slash post, that particular path that you will be specifying over here. Yeah, be careful. Slash post, you need to be careful in specifying that path over here. So this is the second mistake. And the third one is going to be having body parser and express.json. So I think this is the most common mistake everybody does. So when we are like sending data, you need to make use of this app.use express.json. This is a must for posting data. I think it is optional in fetching data. Maybe you can try adding it out. So you need to add another important thing is that your JSON should have this bracket. Once I forgot to like add this bracket and I didn't get an error also, like I wasn't able to do any operation. So you need to use this and also add this bracket. And even after adding this, you are getting an error means that you need to install this body parser thing. All right. So it's a NPM package. I think nowadays it comes inbuilt with Express. But if you're still getting the error, try going to like install this particular command. It's an NPM package. Yeah. NPM I body hyphen parser. Try installing that. So this is the third thing. Use this, app.use express.json with the bracket, okay? Yeah. So this is the third point. And fourth point is for post operation, post raw JSON format. So I will go to my Postman now. So whenever you are performing post operation to Postman, you will be going to like a body, because this is going to be our request payload, all right? So it's going to be body raw. And in this, most majority of the times, we will be sending the data in the form of a JSON structure. So for this, you need to change this, all right, this particular thing to JSON or JavaScript depending upon your use case. In majority of time, the default value will be set as text. So that may also could be a reason for like getting an error when you're posting data. So this is also really hard to notice. So just change it to JavaScript, JSON or XML depending upon your need. The most common thing is obviously JSON format. So this is the fourth point. And the fifth point is going to be services. So this is also a common thing. So you need to just go to search and type services, and you'll be having this services app over here. So just open it. In the services dialog box, just scroll down. So you need to just start your MySQL or MongoDB service, all right? It needs to be started. So that could also be a reason for the error that you're getting. So this is the fifth point. And the final point is going to be obviously the code, because if these are some of the mistakes that you do like with the Postman as well as the packages, but if you are good with the 5 points above, then obviously you have made some mistake with your program or Node.js code. So just verify your Node.js code, especially this part. This is where you people like me including make the mistake in the connection and as well as the post operation, especially even in for the MongoDB as well. This particular path, it's like tricky. Even if you miss some values, it's going to throw you an error, and it's really hard to like find which particular line of code is also like throwing the error. So I think these are some of the ways and common mistakes that I personally made and solved it. So hope you have found this video, and if you think there is even some more like common mistakes that people do, you can just comment it out. And mine is a programming channel as well. I have done many videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, CRUD using Node.js, MySQL, MongoDB. So do check other videos off my channel. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.